Awesome. So I hope I'm visible and audible both. Yeah. All right. Great. So let's begin today's session then. Keep the back and neck straight. Sit comfortably on your mat. And when you feel ready, very gently close your eyes. Start observing your breath. Keep the body aligned. And slowly begin to deepen your breathing. Relax your mind and prepare yourself for Om chanting. Chant Om three times, followed by three shantis. Inhale deeply for Om. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Relax, feel the vibrations. Very slowly join the palms together and rub them together. Gently place them on your eyes. Very slowly while blinking and looking at the palm. Start coming back with a smile. And namaste to everyone. Let us begin today's session. So today also, again, we are learning new pranayama. Yeah. So today we are going to learn Shamadhi. भ्रामरी प्राणायाम, ऑल्सो नोन एज बम्बल बी. इंग्लिश नेम इज बम्बल बी. राइट, सो लेट्स बिगिन. सो भ्रामरी प्राणायाम और बम्बल बी प्राणायाम, द रीजन वाई इट इज कॉल्ड बम्बल बी इज बिकॉज ऑफ द साउंड दैट इज जनरेटेड व्हेन यू डू भ्रामरी. राइट, सो भ्रामरी, दिस वर्ड लिटरली मीन्स बी. You know the black bee that is there, and if it comes into your house, you know it creates that kind of sound, right? Deep type of sound it creates, right? And that is exactly what we are going to do when we do Brahmari. When we generate the sound during Brahmari, it's going to be quite similar to the black bee. The sound, the black bee. You know, makes when they come close to you, right? So in Brahmari, you know, we do Makar chanting. So in your Pranav meditation classes, you would have studied about the Akar, Ukar and Makar chanting. And then you would have gone to the Turyavastha, right? So all these four aspects are covered during your chanting classes, right? And in that, there was this portion Makar, A, U, and then Ma. So how are you making that sound is when you pronounce Makar during this pranayama. So when both the lips are together, right, the mouth is closed, and you create the this sound when you create, that is the Makar sound, right? And that is exactly what we do in Brahmari Pranayama. So a lot of people confuse chanting and Brahmari Pranayama, right? Because when you do chanting, the sound is one of the sounds that you generate, right? But when you do you are generating all the sounds, right, from one state to the other, to the next, to the last stage, right? So do not confuse this thing. Chanting and Brahmari Pranayam are two different things, and it so happens that one of the sounds in is the Makar chanting, right? So again, the posture, let's begin with the posture. Yeah. So, posture is sitting only, right? So, when you go for the posture of Bhramari Pranayama, it is sitting. Right? So, Bhramari, there are a lot of variations of Bhramari Pranayama also that exist, but I will tell you the main one. And I will also tell you the variations, right? So you can change the pranayama depending on who is going to practice it, right? So, but first we will discuss the original technique only, right? So posture is sitting. The things that you have to take care of is that you never practice this in laying position, right? So Brahmari pranayama is a very it's one of the last few pranayams that has been mentioned. And when you see the Bharati Yogic texts, right? And over there, the pranayams are mentioned one after the other. So as you reach the end, you see that they get more and more spiritual. Same thing when you practice Brahmari pranayama. It's mentioned almost at the end. So it's a very, very spiritual practice, right? So Brahmari should never be done while laying down, right? Who should not practice Brahmari? People who have ear infections, right? ENT related issues generally do not go for Brahmari pranayama, but specifically ear infection. Why? Because you have to close the ears. When you go for Brahmari pranayama, you close the ears, and the way in which you close them, if there is severe infection in the ears, it will trigger that, right? If you have a very introverted nature, right, and that's not your aim, right, you don't want to increase that, so avoid Brahmari. Apart from that, Brahmari can be practiced by everyone. It's a very good practice. If you are planning to incorporate retention, at that point of time, heart patients, IBV patients should avoid the retention part of the Brahmari pranayama. Otherwise, it's a very good practice. Again, it is a tranquilizing pranayama. Soothing kind of pranayama. When you even do the makar sound, you feel very, very, feel a soothing impact, right? So in that same way, when it comes in the form of pranayama, it is going to soothe you, right? Just give me a moment. Yeah. Okay. So Brahmari pranayam, very tranquilizing pranayam, great practice to end your entire yoga session with. So you can go ahead, do Shitnishikari first and then go for Brahmari, right? When we see the benefits of Brahmari, has a lot of benefits, right? Not only is it a tranquilizing pranayam on a physical level, it is working on a lot of things, right? So Makar chanting you would have done in your prana classes also. Above the neck region, it's mostly the Makar sound is connected with that. So all the activation of this entire region takes place when you do the Brahmari pranayama, right? The entire activation. So, a blood circulation in this region, especially the vibrations produced around this region, the third eye and nose region. So this region is very, very strongly impacted by the practice of Brahmari pranayama, right? So the activation and the blood flow becoming better in this entire region, that is associated with the practice of Brahmari pranayama. And if you are practicing it regularly, you will even be able to feel this thing. When you do Brahmari, the entire blood flow in your face, that increases, right? Like I said, the vibration is mostly produced over here, right? So in the nose region, right? That is where you feel the vibration. Yeah. So people who have sinusitis, this is a great practice for them, right? Anybody who has sinusitis, even research has shown that Brahmari pranayama helps you to relieve the symptoms and the condition of sinusitis, right? So during sinusitis, this entire your sinuses are very agitated, right? So when you do the Brahmari chanting, there is the production of nitric oxide that takes place, and nitric oxide really helps you with the sinusitis problem, right? So if somebody around you is struggling with this thing, you can definitely make them practice Brahmari. Is going to help them. Like Kapalbhati and Bhastrika, they aggravate the problem of sinusitis if not practiced under the guidance of a teacher. Because if you inhale exhale too fast, or in the case of Kapalbhati, exhalation is active, right? So when you do that, so it causes irritation in the sinuses, right? So but Brahmari is a great practice, right? So it soothes the nervous system to a very great extent and very quickly. So when you practice, when you do Makar chanting, Ruchi, there is a very quick impact of the stressors on your state of mind, right? And overall, it helps in soothing the nervous system. Overall also, body-wise also, you will feel much better when you do Makar chanting because you are ending the practice at that point of time, and it's a very tranquilizing pranayama. So it's going to work on your entire body, you can say indirectly. And directly, I told you this region and above, it's going to show the most impact over here, right? When you see on a mental level, right? So area above this, so your brain, it has a very soothing effect on the brain as well. And you feel very peaceful and calm after doing this pranayama, right? So the frequency of the thoughts which are going on again and again and causing a lot of chaos within you, that seems to go down when you practice Bhramari pranayama, which again helps you in better decision making. So if you have to make any decision to Bhramari, then look at that situation and decide, right? You will see the difference, right? Better decision making, better planning, more productivity in your work you will be able to see. You're able to handle more mental tasks when you do the practice of Bhramari pranayama. Overall, it has amazing impacts, right? And you will see for most therapeutic practices, Bhramari is used because the contraindications are very, very less. So it can be easily used in any therapeutic practice. And most studies that you will find on Bhramari, you will see that, sorry, on pranayama having an impact on a particular condition, you will see the mention of Bhramari being in, sorry, that study. Yeah. Okay. So let's, yeah, emotionally also, again, amazing benefits. You will see you're able to manage yourself and your emotions much, much better. It's a great practice to start your day with, right? It helps you to navigate through your day much better, right? And on a spiritual level, when you would have done the pranic meditation also, ma'am would have mentioned the Makar chanting. Right, and she would have told you the benefits, but it's mostly associated with a higher perception, right? So Brahmari pranayama is also used before meditation, right? So for going into meditation, sometimes pranayama, we use pranayama first and then we introduce the meditation practice. So you will see that Brahmari is the pranayama which is generally used, right? Apart from all the others, Brahmari is the one which is majorly used. And you will also see this thing that to go into certain meditation. So there is this particular meditation which is based on the sound, so Nad meditation, right? And that uses the Brahmari pranayama as a step in the entire meditation process because it's the Makar chanting which brings the mind in such a state where they can sorry, where the mind can be ready for the silent state or the Turiyavastha. That is why you do A, U, Ma, right? So Ma takes you in that stage, the Makar chanting takes you in that stage where you become more spiritually attuned to listen to the silence, the Turiyavastha, right? Experience the Turiyavastha, right? So in Nad meditation also, you are trying to connect with the already existing sound that is present around you and within you, right? And Brahmari pranayama acts as a great bridge to help you to perceive that sound, right? And if you see for even in chanting, the Makar chanting when it is increased, a lot of spiritual benefits are derived out of it. And it's mostly connected with the Agya Chakra, the chakra which is believed to be between both your eyes, the eyebrow center, this portion, right? So that energy center is stimulated and activated when you do the Makar chanting. So this all comes under the benefits of Brahmari pranayama. Again, do not confuse and Brahmari. They are both different practices, but the Makar chanting is similar in both of them, right? So let me go ahead and demonstrate the practice once, then we will practice the pranayama. So we are going to practice it in different ways. So first, I will demonstrate the original practice for Bhramari Pranayam. You adopt the Shanmukhi Mudra, right? So Shanmukhi Mudra, how is it done? With the thumb, you will close the ear. So either you can push this external part inside and close the ear, or you can just insert the thumb inside the ear. However you are comfortable. If you are choosing to insert the thumb inside the ear, just make sure your nails are cut, right? Otherwise, you will end up injuring yourself, right? So closing the ears with the thumb, then index finger is gently placed on the eyes or the eyelashes, however you are comfortable. It's the purpose of the index finger is to close the eyes. The middle finger is going to close the, it's going to aid you to close the nose, but beginner level does not close the nose. They just gently place it over here where your nostrils are, you know, not down, up a little bit. This is where my nostrils are. I can gain that understanding, right? You can also, when you place your hand, you will gain that understanding. So middle finger is placed here. Then the ring finger is placed above the lips and little finger is placed below the lips. So this is the entire position. The elbows are at shoulder level, not to up, not to down, right? And when you place it this way, so either you can, you know, go a little bit ahead. Your elbows can point forward or backward. So that is not the case. If somebody looks at me from that side, they will see straight line. Okay. So this is how Shanmukhi Mudra is done. This is the position you adopt during Bhramari. So don't keep the fingers straight, because then you won't be able to do it correctly. You will like hold the fingers a little bit, and then this is the position that you have to adopt, right? Name, I will just write down the name quickly. This is a Shanmukhi Mudra. This is the specific position for Bhramari Pranayama. Shanmukhi, Shanmukhi Mudra. Right? So let me just demonstrate this one time to you. So your nose is open, you do not close the nose, and we are doing going for simple version. So we are not even going to retain the breath. So you use only the nose to inhale and exhale. You don't open the mouth, okay? So let the makar die out, fade away, right? Like it, when you begin, you go up in the sound, and then the sound goes down, and then you just let it fade away, right? Don't force the sound. Just as your breathing is, you can go ahead and let it die down. So not everybody is able to hold this position. You know, if you want to make somebody practice who is older than you, or who is having a lot of pain, or is unable to hold this position. So how do you go about this practice? So then you use the index finger. You insert this index finger either inside your ear, or you can close the ear by pushing in this cartilage that is present outside. So again, over here, you can just keep the hands like this, or even you can go like this, however you prefer. Right? This is the second variation that you can go for. Yeah. Then the third and the last one, when nobody is, like when you encounter someone who is not able to, you know, do the Shanmukhi Mudra like this, or isn't able to go for the variation for some reason or the other, they're not able to do it. Right? So then you can just make them sit comfortably. Right? And just put the tongue on the upper palate, right? That will help you to feel the vibrations more, right? So placing the tongue on the upper palate, both hands are normally placed on the knees, right? And you inhale. This is the third way in which you can do it. So you will see, if you form the Shanmukhi Mudra, you will be able to feel the vibration much better. Then when you go for only inserting the index finger in your index fingers in your ears, you will feel lesser vibration. And when you don't form any mudra, and just simply place your hands on your knees, then again you will see that the impact is lower. That is why I said that place the tongue on the upper palate so that little bit you are able to feel little bit more, right? Than not having the tongue on the upper palate, right? So we are going to practice all three. Yeah, we have time. So we are going to practice all three, and you can see yourself how the vibration is changing from one practice to the other, right? Apart from this, this is a great practice if you have insomnia, somebody is going through mental stress, tension, anxiety, all of those things, great practice, Samadhi Pranayama, right? So any doubts in the practice, how you have to do it?
No, ma'am.
All clear?
Clear.
Oh, great. So let's go ahead and practice them. Yeah. So keep the back and neck straight. Sit comfortably on your mat. Again, we are going to go for abdominal breathing, yogic deep breathing, anulom vilom, and then we'll go for Bhramari. All three variations, I will be guiding you. So don't worry. Right. Sit comfortably on the mat, keeping the back neck straight. Gently close your eyes. Keep the mind focused on the breathing. Make sure that your body is correctly aligned. And slowly begin to deepen your breathing. We are going to begin with the practice of abdominal breathing. Place your right hand on the abdomen. Exhale completely. And as you begin to inhale, expand your abdomen. As you exhale, contract the abdomen. Continue your breathing, going deeper with each consecutive breath. keep continuing your practice. And relax with each passing breath. Complete three more breaths and then you can suspend the practice of abdominal breathing. Keeping the back and neck straight. Just observe the natural flow of the breath. Prepare yourself for the practice of yogic deep breathing. To feel the need, you can place one hand on the abdomen and on the one hand on the chest. Otherwise, you can just sit comfortably. Keep the back neck straight. Exhale completely. And begin to inhale. Expand the abdomen. And fill the chest up, expanding it completely, giving little bit rise to the collarbones. As you exhale, collarbones drop down, chest goes in, and squeeze the abdomen in properly in order to exhale out all the air from the body. Again, begin to go into the reverse process, inhaling and expanding your lungs to the full capacity. And exhaling, keep continuing this process. Gaining more control over your breathing with each consecutive round. Three more breaths and then you can suspend the practice. keep the back neck straight and just observe how your breath feels. Were you able to gain a little bit more control over your breathing by the end of the practice? Just keep note of these little changes that are coming as you go for different practices of breathing. If you feel the need again, you can change your posture. Keeping the back and neck straight, prepare yourself for the practice of Anulom Vilom. Form the pranava, the Vishnu mudra, with the right hand. Exhale completely and close the right nostril. Begin to inhale through the left nostril. Close the left nostril, exhale through the right nostril. Inhaling with the right nostril again. And then going for exhalation through the left nostril. Complete the round of Anulom Vilom. Go for a few more rounds. Feeling the balancing and soothing impact of Anulom Vilom as you continue your practice. After the round that you're currently performing, go for three more rounds. Once you suspend your practice, just relax your hand, keeping the eyes closed and the back and neck straight. Just observe your breathing feel the need, you can change your posture. Let's prepare ourselves for Bhramari Pranayams. If you are experiencing pain while sitting, just release your posture. And relax your legs. And adopt the different posture. First, we will do the variation where hands are relaxed. We're just going to create the makar sound. So keep the back neck straight, close your eyes. Inhale deeply. And begin your practice. Just continue your practice, going for 7 to 10 rounds. After you complete the rounds, gently relax your hands. Keeping the eyes closed, just focus the attention on the third eye, the space between both your eyebrows. Prepare yourself for the second practice. So again, keeping the back neck straight, gently bring your hands up and plug your ears with the index finger. Inhale deeply and begin your practice. to suspend your practice after the next exhalation. We are going to go for the last variation now. So form the Shanmukhi Mudra properly, closing the ears, the eyes, nose. Don't close your nose, but just place your hands against the nostrils, upper lip, lower lip. We'll go for 10 rounds. Continue the practice. Once you complete all the rounds, just suspend your practice. Bring the hands down, relax your hands. Just gently relax your hands. Keep the back neck straight. Keep your focus on the eyebrow center. Just feel the impact of Bhramari Pranayama. We'll end today's session with one Om and three Shantis. Inhale deeply for Om. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Join the palms together and rub the palms together. Keep them on the ice. very slowly while blinking and looking at the palms, open up your eyes. Start coming back. And namaste to everyone. Are there any doubts, any questions, queries, any difficulties you faced?
No doubts, ma'am.
Oh, great. So I'll see you tomorrow for philosophy and pranayam both. Take care and bye-bye. Om Shanti.
Om Shanti.